have a question. Sometimes my crab apples look terrible and the leaves drop. Can you recommend any other varieties?
So one of the important things about when you're selecting plants is to look for disease-resistant varieties of plants. So crabapples, for example, there are hundreds of different cultivars of crabapples, and they have been bred to be disease-resistant, things like apple scab and anthracnose. When you're choosing a tree, this is an ornamental crabapple, you want to look for plants that are disease-resistant. Now, it's important to realize that resistant does not mean immune. In other words, you may still see signs of a disease, whether it be fungal or bacterial. This is Snowdrift. It's a cultivar, it's an ornamental, it retains its fruit through the winter, which makes it a really good plant for winter interest. However, it has poor resistance to apple scab. And apple scab can cause leaf drop prematurely, and it can also cause the plant to basically defoliate in the summer, so people get very alarmed by that. However, it has good resistance to mildew. Both of these conditions are fungal based. In other words, there are fungal spores that cause these. Now, fungal, if you think of fungi, they like cool, wet, windy weather because it blows those spores all around. And so during seasons when we have a cool, wet, windy spring, we'll see worse apple scab and mildew than we would during a dry, hot spring. One of my favorite disease-resistant cultivars is Donald Wyman. Also, Prairiefire is a great one, and also Adirondack. Those are all terrific disease-resistant cultivars of ornamental crabs.
Ask the Arboretum Experts has been brought to you by the Minnesota Landscape Arboretum in Chaska, dedicated to welcoming, informing, and inspiring all through outstanding displays, protected natural areas, horticultural research, and education.